no matter what you're going through. I know that you can stand, for your life is in His hands.
Situations that come like flood, it will look as though there was no way again. You see God making way in the wilderness. So I have so many testimonies, and I return all the glory to God in the name of Jesus. But mostly I want to testify to the goodness of God concerning this gathering this evening. Actually, devil tried to make sure that this doesn't work. Through manly effort, I know I have tried. And I know that the moment run, it is God that will perfect it. Praise the Lord. In terms of invitation, I invited people. But I know that many we are called, but few we are chosen. And the only thing I'm assuring all of us here that have come to the presence of God is that the way God has been manifesting his glory in my life, I know he will do it. And we have gathered unto God and not unto man or woman. That is one thing we should bear in mind. Those of you who think maybe we are not many, I can see the angels of God all over us. And I can see the host of heaven dwelling in our midst. And I know this gathering is not just ordinary one. And I know by the grace of God that none of us will ever leave this place the same way we came. In the name of Jesus. So I'm thanking God. When we come to this system, is a little note of few witness. At a time it was like one is being discouraged. But God will make sure when there is no way has proved himself real and faithful again. In fact, I have no iota of doubt that God will do anything or not. No. I believe that all he has said concerning today's gathering must surely be fulfilled in our lives. And I give him all the glory who has started it. If I tell you how these things happened, you will see that actually God's hand is in it. Let us now look at the number. See the numerous angels all over us. I see the glory of God radiating all of our lives here. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
It's time for the testimony, and we have one testimony upload. Okay, we still have a testimony. Just one person, then we'll call an evangelist.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This kind God, I never see a type. This kind God, blessed be your holy name. Grateful unto the Lord for making it possible for us to gather here this evening. My testimony goes like this. It's my own, where I am. That is our FGF at Sele Village. The last time our mommy visited us there, there's a woman that discussed with her about the condition she is passing through in her family. Then after all, the mommy said something to me that I should give it to the sister. Well, from that day, the sister came to collect that. Anyway, have been back with me. To the extent that they challenged me, I told them that, what are you talking about? I'm not the one that gave it to her. They said that I'm the one that gave it to her. I said, there's a moment that sent it to me, then I gave it to her. That is in the spiritual, in a dream, we are battling all these things. Then at the end of it, a lot of attack has been going on. Then I know that God has affected that problem to that sister. I was eyeing her now to come out and testify that thing that God has done for you. She says she cannot withstand people here. She says she can, which I know that that problem, God has eradicated out from that family. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's a sickness that comes to the husband and God has done it for her. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord Jesus. Our Lord is good.
Because the Lord is good. Your life today is a testimony. Mm-hmm. You go out every day, you leave your house in the morning and you come back at night. It's testimony. There are some people that they go out, they don't come back. Well, it's not like we are more righteous than them, but it's not our portion. It's a testimony. Praise the Lord. So we are going to call the woman of God, the woman the Lord is using in our midst. And the good thing is that she truly gave herself to work for God. Because there are a lot of people there that the Lord is calling to work for him, but they are not available. So let us call on our evangelist, Mrs. Uloma Ojim, to come and minister to us. Praise the Lord.
Patient of faith as old. Let's close our eyes and stand up as old.
To come and take control. Lord, come and do that which only you can do. Come and do that which only you can do. For our eyes are stayed on you. Blessed be your name, Abba Father.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' most worthy name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Should come and testify. And I saw a lot of testimonies in the lips of some people, but they still sat down on their feet. Does it mean that you did not like the testimony that the Lord gave you? You know, the Bible says that with the words of our testimony, we shamed the devil and overcame very well. So I wonder why you did not want to come and testify. Listen, a miracle working God. And the more you testify, the more the miracles he performs in your life. That is the reason why we actually give opportunity for testimonies. It's not that we don't have the testimonies to tell you people. In fact, the magnitude of testimonies we are experiencing in this 40 days. And singing. I am singing and dancing because our God is good. There is nothing that he has not done for us. In fact,
One of our executives in FTF almost lost the husband. But when they called me, I said, it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. You know, when I say lost the husband, you might think is that he almost went. We are talking about that the husband has gone. We say, no, this one shall return. Because already he was formed. Already the black eyes was gone. But we say, Baba, this particular one, you cannot do it to us. Two of us. In fact, you know, the devil has different kinds of tricks. By the time he was revived, you know what the devil now brought? The devil brought madness. He just jumped up, and that was madness. We also say what? No. This is not the thing. We say you should give us back the man that left. We do not say you should give us the madman. So he has to turn to the man that left. Father, we refuse this and we reject it. Because you know, say that you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. And you know, in this year 2011, our 10th crusade that we said we will begin to plan is called Making Jesus Famous Crusade. But there is a portion that is written Miracle Crusade there. So we believe God that for every crusade we are holding, that there will be multiple miracles that will happen in on the ground. And I am saying this because I have seen God do his thing his own way. And I know that I don't have any power of my own, but I know that the God that has sent me has all the power. Because the scripture says, once it was written, but twice I read that all power belongs to who? God. The way God did it for us is such that our mouth up to today is very speechless. God returned her husband, and the husband has started work present here as I'm speaking with you. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee?
Look at us and ask, who are these that fly like the clouds? If you are part of FGF indeed, people are supposed to look at the magnitude of happenings in your life and say, what is standing? I don't care what you're going through, but after what the Lord said I should do here tonight, you will find out that we still serve a God that answers by fire. I want to read from the scriptures. The book of John chapter 11. You know, the Bible says that they came and told Jesus that his friend that he loved is sick. And you know, John is the brother of the woman that actually washed the feet of Jesus with her tears and dried it with her hair. If you read verse 1, he said, now a certain man was sick, Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. And it was that Mary who anointed the Lord with fragrant oil and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. It was this same Mary that understood the power in feet washing. And she did it for Jesus, but now the brother was sick. But God just said, Jesus just said, that this sickness is not unto death, but for the name of God to be glorified. What do we want to bring out from there? Listen, let me tell you something. I don't care what you are going through. I don't care the challenges that is facing you right now. But I want you to know something tonight. That challenge, that thing you are going through, is not for you to be put to shame. It's for the name of God to be glorified. Am I making sense? Listen, in that same place that the enemy has tried to put you to shame, that is the same place that my God will glorify you. Because the Lord is said to beautify you this night. After tonight, every sickness that is attacking you and bringing you tears, they will let go of you forever. I am saying this because that is what the Lord has said to me before I have come here. Before I came here, the Lord said to me that I'm going to come here with the healing anointing. But you know one thing I like about God? He also understands that some afflictions are actually sickness in disguise. How many of you know that poverty is a sickness? How many of you know that struggling is a sickness? How many of you know that begging is a sickness? After tonight, you will be healed. I want to read the scripture of what I'm going to do tonight. Because I'm not going to take much of your time. I'm just going to make it brief. It is all about the presence of the Holy Spirit. It is not how long we gather. It is how effective the Spirit within us is. Am I making sense? Immediately the Spirit of God visits us, the testimony is short. So why then are we still remaining here? Am I making sense? I want you to close your eyes. And I want you to pray like you have never prayed before. I want you to cry out, my Father, do not pass me by tonight. Open your mouth and pray. My Father, do not pass me by. 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 Do not pass me by, Lord. Do not pass me by, Lord. Do not pass me by. In Jesus' name we pray. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. We have come to touch the hem of your garment, O Lord. Father, let virtually
receive heaven right now and flow into the lives of everybody represented here. This year shall be a golden year for them. A year of triple honor, triple achievement, triple celebration, triple glory in the name of Jesus. Father, tonight they shall contact the anointing of speed in accomplishment. They shall contact the anointing of speed in accomplishment. Release your angelic host right now. And let them come and deliver their blessings into their hands. In the mighty name of Jesus. Tonight, the Lord said to me that we should embark on what he has called the blood of sprinkling. I want to return your Bibles to the book of Hebrews chapter 12, and I read from verse 18. Sorry, I'm reading from 22. Praise the Lord. But you have come to Mount Zion. Are you there? Okay, you might not be able to see, so just listen to me while I read. Praise the Lord. But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. I want you to understand something. I want you to know that it's not by mistake that you are here today. I want you to know that because we have gathered ourselves here to call upon the name of the Lord, that this place is no longer ordinary ground. It has turned to our Mount Zion for now. And because it has turned to Mount Zion, the presence of angels are here. Am I making sense? The Bible says that you have come to Mount Zion, to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels, to the General Assembly, the Church of the Firstborn, who are registered in heaven. I want you to know that because you came here today, that you have been registered in heaven. And to God, the Judge of all, I don't care what it is that has bothered your heart, but you have come to a judge that will plead justice in your own favor. Praise the Lord. He said, and to God, the judge of all, and to the spirit of just men made perfect, to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaks better things than the blood of Abel. Praise the Lord. Listen, I just told you the testimony of our sister who the Lord revived the husband from the sleep of death. I was testifying to one sister and she said to me, another sister in FGF, that she said that a pastor came and saw a vision for her, that he saw a vision and there was a plane crash and that her husband was part of the plane crash. But you know, because we have trained that sister so well, she replied to them and said that you did not see well. Don't be offended. But that you see, in this year, my husband, his achievements, he has not even started it. Now can you sit down? Let me tell you some of the things he needs to achieve. There's another company he's planning to open, and you know he has to open it this year. And he has to run it this year. And that me and my children, we're also planning to